Hello and welcome, dear children. Let us continue with Standard 7th English, Chapter Number 1.4, The King's Choice. In a previous part, we have understood that there was a lion and he decided to have a court and he selects fox, leopard and vulture as his courtiers. Okay, so let us continue now. We all know, children, that the lion had promised these courtiers food and protection. And these courtiers in return have to be very loyal to the king. They had to find food also for him. One day what happens is the vulture goes on a flight. And when he comes back, he straight away goes to the king, the lion. And he says, "Your Majesty, have you ever eaten a camel?" The king says, "No, I have not." And he had never seen, this animal around him. Why? Because you will always find these animals in the desert, mostly in the desert. Now, which is the desert? Which is this place? How it is? You all must have studied in geography. This desert place is such a place where you will not find much of water. You will find very little amount of water over there. It is very dry. Then the soil is in the form of sand. Very few creepers stay over there. Only big animal like camel. Camel is known as the ship of the desert. Do you know why? Why this camel is known as the ship of the desert? Yes, because it can stay without water for 3 days. It has a hump on its back, if you have seen. It stores water over there. So whenever he feels thirsty, that stored water is useful for his body, right? So only a few animals, just like camel, snakes, some creepers, then the plants like cacti, cactus, can survive over there because it's too hot. Or the other animals, we cannot survive. It's very tough time over there. So he's telling the king, he's insisting him to have the meat of camel. Other two, like the leopard and the fox, also agrees to this idea. And they all go to the desert. And when they move on over there, you can keep an image of a forest and you can keep an image of a desert. There's a drastic change. A forest is a place where you'll find so many trees around you, isn't it, children? And it's very cool over there. But as you move on to the deserts, what happens is it starts turning hotter and hotter. It becomes so deserted. Your faraway places, you will not find any trees around you, no greenery around you. Okay, open lands with strong breeze where sand is moving here and there. It's very tough time to walk in the deserts. So let's see now what happens further when these lion, vulture, fox, and the leopard are going in the desert. What happens is, as they move to the deserted land, in the deserts, the paws of the lion starts burning. You know what is a paw, no? The feet of the lion. You must have seen cats. Just like that, a lion, a leopard also has a paw. Okay, so it started burning and he says, "Oh my God, I cannot move on further. Just stop, everybody, just stop over here. I don't want to eat the camel's milk, the camel's meat. Just stop over here." And everybody stops. Okay, so let's see what happens next. Before that, we will read whatever I have explained. One day, the vulture came back from a flight. "Your Majesty, have you eaten a camel?" he asked. "It's very tasty. I ate it once in the desert." The lion had never seen a camel, but he liked the idea of trying camel's meat. "But where can we get a camel?" he asked. "There is a desert some miles away," said the vulture. I was flying over it when I saw a lone. Now, what do you understand by the word lone? Lone means to be alone, single. Okay? So, he saw a camel who is moving in the desert, which is alone, nobody around them. Why they are hunting for a lone camel? Because it's very easy to catch them then. When you are single, when you are alone, anybody can attack you very easily, rather in a group, right? So he says, I've already seen one camel, so don't worry, he's alone over there. Okay, it looked big and fat. The lion looked at his other advisors. They were wise and experienced. He wanted their opinion. Now, the fox and the leopard did not know the desert, but they did not want the vulture to seem wiser than them. So they said, since it was the vulture's idea, he should lead the way. Now you see, everybody wanted to prove wise and good that they are best in front of the king. So even fox and the leopard did not want to remain back. They also wanted to show that yes, they also want to do much more things for the king. They wanted to impress him. They wanted to be in his favor. Okay, so they also agreed, and like that, all the animals started moving the next morning to the desert. Okay, so let's read that also now. Early next morning, the lion and his court started off on the camel hunt. They reached the edge of the desert easily, but after they left the shelter of the forest, the day became very hot. The sun shone down with fire hot rays. Fire hot rays means it was very, very hot over there. Okay. High up in the cool air, the vulture flew. Hurry along, he called. The camel is not far off. But the lion could not hurry anymore. The hot sand had burnt his paws. I told you, no? What are the paws? Okay. He could go no further. Stop, he shouted to the others. Let us go back to the forest. I do not care to try camel meat. The Lion King's advisors were frightened. The forest was far behind them, and they did not know how to get the lion back home. The leopard wanted to run away. The vulture wanted to watch and wait and eat the lion later on. But the clever fox thought of a plan. Okay, now till here we have seen that the vulture is leading the way of the lion. Why? Because only he knows the way to the desert as he flies. You know what is a vulture? No, the vulture bird always eats the dead bodies of humans, then the birds or animals. When they die, later the vulture goes and eats them up, even the microorganisms and all, everything it can eat and digest very well. Okay, and it can fly very high. It sees, you know, wherever the dead bodies are there, you'll find vultures in the sky. Okay, so he is very sharp and he knows the way. But other two were scared when the king said, you know, that let's go back to the forest, because you know they did not know the way back home, so they got frightened. At the same time, vulture wanted to eat the lion when he dies, because lion may not survive in the deserts. As he lives in the forest, he may not survive in the desert. He knew that. So he was waiting for the lion to die, and when he dies off, the vulture wanted to eat him. And the other two got scared because they did not know the way back home. So now, as you all know, fox is very sharp. He's very thoughtful. He's very talented. What does a fox do? He makes a plan. Then he goes himself in the desert. Somehow he finds the animal, the camel, okay, and he makes friendship with him. He makes camel his friend. He tries to convince when the camel is not ready to come back. He says, your master is dead, your master is killed, and now you do not have any master, because the camel was not ready to come. No, he says, I am loyal to my master. I have a master and I have to be loyal to him. So without him, I cannot go anywhere else without his permission. But what did the fox convince? Fox says that your master is no more. Do you think the fox was telling truth? No, he was telling a lie so that camel goes along with him. Okay, so I'll read the next part now. But the clever fox thought of a plan. Off into the desert he ran, saying, I will bring some help. After running for some time, the fox found the camel. The camel was indeed surprised to see him. You must have come across this word, no children? Surprised. What do you understand by surprised? Can you make a sentence on this word? Come on, try out in your mind. Yes, I'll help you with one. I was surprised to see a beautiful frog on my birthday. Yes, so that expression, you know, you are surprised. Suddenly something comes and it's amazing and you get surprised. Okay, so even the camel was surprised to see whom? The fox, because we never find foxes in the desert. So he was surprised to see him. Hurry up, friend camel, said the fox. Our king wants you at once. Your king? Said the camel. Who is that? I do not know any king. I only know my master, for whom I carry goods across the desert. As I all told you in part 1, that what is the work of the camel? It is called the ship of the desert. And what does it do? It carries load from one place to another. Okay, because no vehicles and all, you know, because of the sand, they cannot move faster. So camel is the only mode of transport. So he says, I am loyal to my master and I cannot go without his permission. Our king, the lion, has killed your master, said the fox. Now you are free. And the lion has invited you to live at his court. Come along. The camel followed the fox. When the fox and the camel reached the lion's camp, the vulture and the leopard were surprised. Even the king looked pleased, in spite of his burned paws. The camel was presented to the king. He agreed to serve the lion in return for a home at his court. Get on the camel's back, your majesty, said the fox. We will return home. The lion at once jumped on the camel's back. His courtiers, the fox and the leopard, jumped up behind him, and with the vulture flying ahead as a guide, they set off on the long journey back to the forest. When the travelers reached the forest, they were all tired and hungry. The fox, the leopard, and the vulture looked at the camel when they looked at each other and smiled hungry smiles. I shall stop over here, children. In this para, what it is told is, you know, somehow the fox, you know, convinces the camel to come along with him, and the camel goes. And when the camel is presented as a gift to the king, so what does the camel say? That, you know, my master is not there, he's no more, I do not have a home now. So can you please, you know, promise me to give a home in at your court? So of course it is agreed by the king, and you know, they all start, you know, climb on the camel's back, all of them. First lion and the other two sit behind him, that is the fox and the leopard. So all three on the camel's back and the vulture leading their way home. And somehow they reach to the forest, and when they reach the forest, they are so tired and at the same time they are very, very hungry. And as they had planned, what they wanted to have? They wanted to have the camel's meat. What did the vulture want to have? The vulture wanted to have the meat of the king, that is lion. See how everybody is cunning and wicked, you know, they are planning their own ways to have each other, to eat up each other, right? So they were all looking at each other with hungry smiles. They were very hungry and they were ready at any time to pounce on the camel's back to eat him up. They were just waiting for the orders of the king. So I hope everybody has understood till here, children. The remaining part will finish up in the next part of the lesson.